Mr. Johnson, thank you so much.
Ernie, thank you so much.
How is this different from doing the NBA? What's the big difference between the two?
All right, of course.
I mean, basically, we're doing basketball.
We've got copy for Reese's. Who likes
look? The difference is there are so many more teams to prepare for than in the NBA. You got 30 teams in the NBA. You got 68 teams that make the field and another 20 or 30 who might, so you're doing a lot of work that way. But the biggest difference between this and the NBA is that the raw emotion that you see from coaches and players when it's over, you know, like a coach realizes he'll never coach a certain player again, a player realizes he may never play the game again. That's what you get here that you can never get in the NBA.
Right, and so you went to the University of Georgia?
Yes, I did. Go Dogs. Sick them.
How have you seen this competition grow? All right,
I'm thinking back. I mean, I was in college in the 70s, long before you were born.
All right, finals. You three.
And it was popular then, but it's just taken on a whole new popularity and a whole and the access to the tournament is different. With our arrangement with CBS, you know, have every game is on, you know, CBS, TBS, TNT, through TV. You can't miss a game. And so and just the whole way we watch TV and social media and everything, everybody is so dialed into the tournament. It's gotten so big and will only get bigger.
Right. From your perspective, how has social media played in the growth of basketball?
Well, I think the ability for people to react and interact instantaneously. A guy hits a shot, everybody in the world is talking about it together. It's a wonderful thing, an amazing thing to watch.
Now, who do you think is going to win come Monday?
Make some noise.
If I'm forced to make a pick, I'm saying North Carolina. And that's because I had them picked in my bracket before it all started.
Make some noise.
It's the only team I have left. So North Carolina.